The gig economy seeing a significant boom globally. That's according to Cohen Wivneski of freelancers.com. According to him, 2 million of their users are based in the Philippines and focus on skills such as design, data entry, and virtual assistants. He also cites several factors that gave freelancing a boost worldwide.
We see that because of a few reasons. Main one is because of economic struggles in recent times, whether that's due to inflation or the effects of COVID lockdowns. But we're seeing a lot of freelancers are actually signing up in recent years to kind of supplement their work or actually move to full-time freelancing as their main source of income.
Foreign direct investments into the Philippines significantly declined in October. The Banco Central says the $655 million net inflows was lower by nearly 30% from the same period in 2022. Monetary authorities point to higher debt instruments of $504 million for the decrease in net investments. Equity capital placements also plunged by 54% or to $74 million from the previous $163 million. Most of the placements were from Japan, the U.S., and Singapore and were channeled to manufacturing, real estate, and the financial and insurance sectors. From January to October, net FDI inflows were lower by 17.5% at $6.5 billion. The BSP says a recent decline mirrors the impact of inflationary pressures and slowing global growth prospects. One of the framers of the 1987 Constitution fears its political provisions may also be amended. The legal luminary René Sarmiento opposed changes to the charter and instead called for the passage of more laws to attract foreign investments into the country. He also cites a Supreme Court decision which ruled that major constitutional amendments cannot be done through a people's initiative.
Possibly po maggalaw po ang political provisions. Kasi po kung tutusin po natin, pag-uusap-usapan po sa mga munisipyo, sa probinsya, ang pagbabago po ng term limits. This is not insubstantial or insignificant. So para sa akin po, kahit economic provisions, kailangan po ang Constituent Assembly or Constitutional Convention. Hindi po kailangan po ang initiative, which is for minor amendments.
Philippine Interior Secretary Benner Abalo sees a people's initiative that's pushing for amendments to the Constitution as a valid exercise of everyone's rights. Abalo says there's nothing wrong if people should show support for the people's initiative through a signature campaign. But having said that, Abalo says his office is not involved in the signature drive.
Wala po tayong participation na bawal po kasi sa ahensya na gumalaw sa ganyan. No, we only, it's people's initiative. Dapat manggaling sa tao mismo po yan.
A people's initiative seeking amendments to the Philippine Constitution, eyeing a comeback. The People's Initiative for Reform, Modernization and Action, or PIRMA, aired on Tuesday a paid advertisement carrying calls to amend the charter. PIRMA first pushed for a charter change during the administration of former President Fidel Ramos.
Ang purpose ho nitong advertisement na napanood ho ninyo is to bring into public discussion, pwede na ba natin pag-usapan yung People's Initiative to amend the Constitution? Panahon na ba? At kung pwede na, ano ba gusto ninyong isama doon sa mga proposed na ipopropose na mga amendments?
Albay Representative Edsa Lagman called the ad a campaign to demonize the EDSA People Power Revolution, which ousted the Marcos dictatorship. Meanwhile, House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro wants to file a House resolution probing the funding of the ad. PIRMA's law firm earlier said private funds were used for the initiative.
The Philippine Coast Guard successfully conducts a resupply mission to the Calayan Island Group in the West Philippine Sea. The PCG delivered essential supplies to Coast Guard personnel in the islands of Lawak, Panata, and Pag-asa. Coast Guard Commandant Ronnie Gavan says they plan to boost the PCG's response and monitoring capabilities on the three islands. Gavan notes the PCG intends to make this possible by utilizing its additional budget for infrastructure development.
The German foreign minister is set to arrive in the Philippines on Thursday for an official visit. Berlin's top diplomat, Annalena Baerbock, will be in the country until Friday on the invitation of Philippine Foreign Secretary Enrique Manalo. She is set to meet President Marcos and hold bilateral talks with her Philippine counterpart. Baerbock's itinerary will include a stop at the Philippine Coast Guard headquarters. She is the first German foreign minister to visit the country in over a decade. The two nations mark this year the 70th anniversary of the establishment of their diplomatic ties.